Why does there have to be a Tesla killer?
Today's video is going to be, why do we need a Tesla killer at all? Every single new car, electric car that comes out now is the new Tesla killer. Tesla's finished. Why do we need that? So there doesn't have to be a Tesla killer. I'm in a Tesla, obviously. I'm driving Dean's Tesla. Dean's not told his wife, so hi, Sam. Because Sam will obviously like that. So, ooh, camera's all over the place. Where are you going?
I can't drive the camera.
Just don't press the button. Just leave it. It'll follow me. So, yeah, we're doing some public outreach today about electric cars in general. There is basically a normal car show in Rotherham in Sheffield. And Dean did the show last year. And we're just going to sit there and sit in front of the Model X and explain electric cars to them. Not just Tesla, every electric car, because at the end of the day, Tesla can't make every single electric car for every single human being, and nor can every single human being afford a Tesla. And this is precisely why you don't need a Tesla killer. Dean basically has driven most electric cars, and he's also got a Zoe, haven't you, Dean?
That's right, yep.
So what is the Rotherham show like, and what was it like last year when you went?
Well, Rotherham show, where am I? Let me find myself. There we go. Right, so, Rotherham show. Just thought I'd do a bit of interest, spread the word about EVs, as I'm sure a lot of Nick's followers know that there's a lot of misinformation out there about electric cars, and just thought I'd test the water, see what response I got. The good news was, there were that many people that actually came to look around the car. We got asked to move the car, because people were leaning on other cars to take pictures of it and ask questions about it, and I literally didn't get a minute all day at the show, which was fantastic. It got the attention of the mayor, which got the council talking about electric cars.
So you basically invited...
It was a very productive, productive day.
You basically invited me here so you can go to the toilet. Dean last year said it was so bad he had to ring his wife to come down to the show to stand with the car while he went for a wee.
That is right. It was so busy.
So
yeah, it was good. Good that people show interest in electric cars.
Yeah, and good news is it's sunny today in Sheffield. Sunny Sheffield is...
It always is.
Yeah, it's always sunny in Sheffield.
Sunny South Yorkshire.
Yeah, sunny Sheffield is always sunny. Not. It will probably rain later on.
It feels like it this year.
Yeah, it will definitely rain later on, 100%, and we will get soaked. So we'll see you at the show. Next level. This weekend wasn't just about Tesla, it was about all electric cars. We went to the show to promote the benefits of every single electric car on the road today. The Tesla Model X was taken down as it's a showpiece. It gets people there, it gets people interested. We've put it into party mode to draw a crowd and get people talking around it, walking around it, asking questions. If we had money for every time someone asked me where the engine was, people didn't even know what Teslas were. It was great to promote the whole atmosphere of electric cars. People said, how much is this car? You tell them how much the Tesla price starts at for the Model X, and they suddenly go, oh, that's expensive. We'll never all be driving electric cars. Then you tell them how much a Zoe is, how much an i3 is, how much a Leaf is. And then when they find out how much they can buy a brand new Nissan Leaf or a brand new Renault Zoe, they suddenly go, oh, well, that's actually not that bad. You then tell them the running costs, how much it costs to run. Then their interest gets even perked even more. Even the people who were completely against electric cars were completely converted by the cost element. There's obviously people who were there who did care about the environment, who converted straight away as soon as you told them how green they were and that you could charge them at night on a 100% green tariff, which is even cheaper than normal electric. At the end of the day, Tesla can't make every single car for every single person, and not every single person wants a Tesla. Some people want to own a BMW, and some people want to own a Ferrari. And at the end of the day, they only want to buy those makes and models. So no one's going to eat into Tesla's market, because at the end of the day, there's still buyers out there that will want a Tesla, that will want a BMW, that will want a Renault. People buy the brands they want, and the people buy the brands they trust. Well, that was an interesting day. If you ever want to be asked every single EV question myth ever, go to a petrol car show where everyone will walk up to you and ask you every single myth. Next year, me and Dean are going to have a money jar, and every time someone says how long does it take to charge, we're going to donate £1 to charity.
Yeah,
all right then, we're going to donate a penny to charity, and there'll probably be £100 at the end of the day. Easy. A lot of the questions that I kept asking people were, weirdly, my subject today was Tesla. You know, there's no such thing as a Tesla killer, and everyone kept telling me how there's a new BMW coming out that's going to kill Tesla. And supposedly Tesla are never going to take off, their stocks are down the pan and there's no money left.
What about the self-driving electric car?
Don't!
How many people asked you about that?
One. That guy at the end of the day. Yeah.
Right, I've had three.
Oh, you've had three. Well, yeah. The guy at the end of the day told me, Toyota have got a self-charging car. Literally, no joke.
I thought they were winding you up.
Do you think you're winding me up? It worked. Dean's going to go and sort that table out in the back. But yeah, it was an exciting day, and as I've explained to lots of people, not one car company alone can produce all the electric cars needed for every single person who drives a car. Tesla just fill a market in the premium sector, and now they're biting into a non-premium sector with the Model 3, and there's other car manufacturers that will pick up the other sections and other parts of the market. Tesla, in my mind, will always be a dominant electric car seller and will always own the mass majority share of electric cars. And the reason is, they have the best technology, they've been working on it for longer, and to me, a Tesla is almost like the Ferrari badge standard of electric cars. Would you agree with that, Dean?
Yes, although I only heard half of that.
That basically, electric cars are rubbish, and you know...
They'll never catch on.
Yeah, they'll never catch on. Yeah. But yeah, no, basically saying that Tesla are the to me, Tesla are the Ferrari of electric cars. They'll always be wanted. They're a premium wanted car.
In a sense, they've managed to create a premium brand, haven't they?
Yeah. Every single kid who walked past, that's a Tesla, I want one of them when I'm older.
True, yeah. Appeals to 10-year-olds.
Yeah, it appeals to 10-year-olds. Yeah. And those 10-year-olds, when I was a 10-year-old, it was, I want to have a Ferrari.
Yeah, there you go.
So those 10-year-olds now are saying, I want a Tesla.
Ferrari.
Now what, Tesla?
Yeah, they kind of lost their appeal a little bit, aren't they, combustion engines?
Yeah, combustion engines aren't the fun that they used to be. And the shock on everyone's face when we told them that this Model X is the slow Model X and it does 0 to 60 in 5 seconds.
Yep.
I'm waiting for you to correct me.
4.9. Sorry. I knew you were waiting for me. I just thought I'd see if you'd move on. Obviously not, but yeah. How many times did we get asked, so where's the engine in this then? Because obviously so there wasn't one in the boot, one under the bonnet. And then when we told them there wasn't one, it's an electric motor, then we got asked, how many litres is it? How many miles per gallon does it do?
How far does it go on a charge?
Yeah. How long does it take to charge it up?
You see, this is the best...
Where do you charge it?
When Robert on the Fully Charged does impressions of non-electric car owners, he needs to just put a Yorkshire accent on.
Yeah, like literally everybody.
A lot of the people came up to us were, how far does it go? How long does it take to charge? Literally every myth question known to man. 22 times I got asked, how long do the batteries last?
How much does it cost? Fill it up.
Yeah, how much does it cost to replace the battery after the 7-year warranty? It was the number one question I got asked. Yeah, 8-year warranty on Tesla, sorry. How much does it cost to change the battery when the warranty runs out? And the question is, the answer I gave is the car most likely will be dead before the battery.
In fairness though, joking apart, it was really good to see so many people who'd not really heard of electric cars. So many people had never heard of Tesla before, which I was surprised at.
Loads of people didn't know it was a Tesla. Loads.
And they're all, to be fair, they're all genuine questions that people want to know the answers to. And unfortunately, there's been a bit of misinformation out there. But
the thing
that's why we did what we did. It was a good day. We've had a good day, haven't we?
The thing I've enjoyed the most was 7 people said to me after talking to me and having a debate about electric cars, they went, "You convinced me." They walked away from me and went, "You convinced me." Yeah. "You're right, you convinced me."
So,
initial thoughts on the Tesla Model X? Handling, driving?
Model X is great. Autopilot is scary as hell. Now, there's a video somewhere of the first time me and Dean went out in his Tesla Model X and he took me on autopilot, and I'll throw it on the screen for a couple of minutes.
You still not asked me to hold the steering wheel.
It's really scary, the fact that you've been driving it this long that you've got so much confidence in the car that I've just realised you've been driving down the road touching the sat-nav for about 40, 50 seconds and not even looked.
Keep having a slight glance, honestly.
But it basically scared the hell out of me then. Sitting in the driving wheel and pressing the autopilot for the first time is way more scary than being the passenger. Way more scary, especially when it's not your car. You know that Dean's wife will literally kill you. Literally kill me. And Dean will probably help finish me off. So it's extremely nerve-wracking. But I will say this. This does not feel the size it is. It feels a very small car. A very small car. Was I supposed to go in there?
No. Keep going.
All right. It doesn't feel the size it does. It doesn't feel like a massive Range Rover. It feels like an Audi A4 or something more that size. Now, this car is actually bigger than the Range Rover, but it doesn't feel bigger. And Dean's also put the new wheels on, and it drives like the Roadster. It's really tight. Drives really tight. Me neck. Oh, I did. As always, don't forget to click the subscribe button, check out the other videos down here, and consider becoming a patron. I'll see you again next week. Thanks very much for watching. Goodbye.